Welcome to today's Grow It Green. I'm with Margaret Hagen from the UNH Cooperative Extension Service. We're at La Valley Farms in Hooksett, and we're surrounded by some very interesting looking things, Margaret. But there's another side to these squash, and that is they're also some pretty good eating, right?
They are. Winter squash make great eating, and they keep for a long time, which is also nice. So you can store them for 3 months sometimes, or even longer.
If I want to store them, where do I need to put them? Obviously, you can't let them freeze, right?
No. If you have a big winter squash, you're going to not have room for it in your refrigerator. So the best place is probably a cool basement, and if you can keep it somewhere between 50 and 60 degrees, they'll just keep for up to 3 to 4 months easily.
Okay. Let's talk about a little bit of the eating, and probably the squash that most people are familiar with, the acorn squash, great roasted, steamed, a little bit of brown sugar and maple syrup maybe.
Slice it in half, put it in a baking dish.
All right. And now we've got one that's similar in flavor to it, right?
Right. That's a little small, sweet squash, and if you're only one person, that might be something that you want to do instead of an acorn squash because it's quite a bit smaller but basically has the same flavor.
Okay. Now, what do we have here?
That's a spaghetti squash, and a lot of people will cut that in half and steam it, and when you scoop the inside out, it looks like long noodles. Sometimes people will eat it with tomato sauce, but actually it's also really good roasted and then served with butter and salt.
Okay, and if you use a fork too, you almost get like the spaghetti
strings. You almost get like rice noodles.
All right, we have here a Hubbard squash. Now,
yeah.
I'm familiar with blue Hubbards.
This is golden Hubbard, and the reason you might want to buy this is because blue Hubbards can be huge. So this probably weighs about 4 pounds, and each pound of raw squash will end up being about a cup of cooked squash. So you have to have a fairly good sized family for even this, but a blue Hubbard is usually 2 or 3 times the size. So this is an option for a smaller.
Okay. We have less than a minute left, and okay. So I want to get to some of these others very quickly here.
This is delicata. A lot of people like this. It's very thin-skinned. It has a nutty, slightly corn-like flavor, and it's great roasted and also steamed.
Okay. And two more to go.
Right. This is an amber cup squash. It's very similar to your butternut squash. They both have pretty much the same kind of a flavor. Yeah. And the nice thing about butternut is it's all-purpose, so you can use it for pretty much anything.
Great soups.
Easy to peel. You can also freeze it. And the reason it makes grape soup is because it's not fibrous. So when you puree it, it comes out really smooth and creamy.
All right. So a lot of different options here, a lot of different shapes. And just get out there and try some of these. You may find you've got a new favorite. That's it for today's Grow It Green. Back to you in the studio.